it's possible that you're not an illegal dispatcher. Is it possible?
Under certain circumstances, yes. And I get a lot of feedback on this. I have a couple very good friends that strongly disagree with me on this topic. I've even had conflicting opinions from attorneys I've consulted about this topic. The problem is the regulations are so vaguely worded, and the court opinions that deal with brokers generally are dealing with broker's liability for lost or damaged shipments and other stuff under the Carmack Amendment and not illegal brokering. Very few people actually file a complaint about illegal brokering. Now, that said, in August, the Transportation Intermediaries Association, which is the largest trade association of brokers, did file a petition with FMCSA for clarification of the difference between a broker and a dispatch service. This is not unique to Hotshot. It is not unique to auto transport. These dispatch services are popping up throughout the entire transportation industry. And in fact, some of our earlier forms of managed transportation at auctions possibly could have been illegal broker services because they were arranging transportation for vehicles they didn't own or have the right to arrange transportation for. Sometimes they weren't even coming back to the auctions facility. That's a whole nother show. But on this subject, if you follow the flow chart and start up at the top, you, the dispatcher, broker, the person who wants to decide, do you represent more than one motor carrier? If not, then no, you're an agent of that motor carrier, even if you're an independent contractor. Where it gets fuzzy is when you have more than one motor carrier you represent as an independent contractor. Then we have to look at where does the freight come from that you dispatch. If you're only logging into a load board or dealing with a broker that one of your motor carriers has a relationship, so you call up and, hey, this is Jim from XYZ, I'm calling on behalf of ABC Trucking and I want to book that load. That is a bona fide agent. That is not a broker. We can all follow along so far, right? That makes sense.
Yeah.
I see the broker shaking his head. So, but now when we get
into, I see the broker shaking his head.
But awesome. When we get into the mixed sources, this is where we blur the line and where a lot of dispatchers cross the line and are infringing upon broker and should have broker authority and the broker bond. So if the sources are coming from multiple sources, the next qualifier is, do you have one single motor carrier pre-committed before you, the dispatch service, accept the load? If I'm a dispatcher, I can't call up Joe's Ford in Phoenix, Arizona and say, hey, I want a load going to New York. Okay, yeah, sure. I have to have a trucking company that has asked me to find them freight from Phoenix, Arizona to New York before I can go trying to solicit that work. The same thing if I have people calling me up, I advertise I'm ABC Trucking Dispatch Service, and I have people calling me up, hey, can you get my load moved for me? I have to say no, unless I have a motor carrier that has already asked me to find a load in that lane. So the whole key is you have to be acting on behalf of one individual trucking company at a time. You can repeat this process 100 times a day for 100 different trucking companies, but when you're on that phone call or on that load board or talking to that shipper to find a load, you must be working for one specific motor carrier at that moment, and you can't say, oh, good, this is a good fit for Joe, but I'm working on Tom's load right now. You can't say, oh, yeah, I'll take that one, and then sell it to Tom later. Now you've become a broker. So then this is where a lot of people cross the line because they have the contacts. They start gathering up customers of their own, and, well, now you are a broker service. You're offering transportation by motor carrier. Then you do not own trucks. That makes you a broker, not a dispatcher, unless you are contracted with a motor carrier and you're representing them. I know that sounds like a lot of doublespeak, but I tried to make it as simple as I can for as complex as this issue is.
I think you did a great job. And what I find so interesting is it doesn't seem like there's a lot of clarity on what a dispatcher is or does. There's a lot am I wrong?
No, you're not, because there is no definition of a dispatcher. The only two definitions in the regulations are the definition of a broker and the definition of a bona fide agent of a motor carrier. Those are the only two that are clearly defined. So a dispatcher does not exist in the eyes of the FMCSA. It's a relatively new concept to have independent back office staff making these negotiations for you. Normally, it's been a employee of the company, the owner of the company, the owner operator in a single truck would sit in the truck stop. Remember when brokers used to have offices at the major truck stops, or you had the DAT TV screen in the corner and you pick the payphone up and call? Yes, you'd sit in the diner. That's why every table had a phone at the table for you. You, as the owner of the trucking company, when you're a one truck company, were making these calls while you're sitting still having your meals. Well, today with technology and the love for outsourcing, which, believe me, I'm a proponent of outsourcing. That's how I make my living, is doing compliance work for trucking companies. We just want to give all this away and just drive the truck. Well, so these dispatch services have popped up to fill a need, but if they're crossing that line into broker territory, then I have to say they need to get their broker authority, get their bond, and do it right.
But what's really happening, as we see on Dispatching Live regularly, is you've got carriers that fit right on this flow chart and fall into needing a broker bond. How do you like those apples?
I'll agree with you on that one, Jay, because it used to be there was an old concept under the Interstate Commerce Commission days called interlining, where a carrier was exempt from having a broker's license if they gave the load to another licensed motor carrier. This was back when you had to have rights to run certain lanes, and you could go east loaded but come back west empty, so you would interline or you would trip lease. It used to be a carrier could give that load away without a problem to another real licensed motor carrier. That changed, about 10 years ago or so, and now if a carrier wants to be in the business of giving away their excess freight, they have to be a broker. Well, unless they sign an interline agreement or a trip lease agreement where that other trucking company is actually running it under their number for that particular load. Well, and that gets into who owns freight and bill of lading and blah, blah, blah.
Well, in this giving it away of interlining, can the first carrier profit from arranging for the freight to the second carrier? Can he take his cut? Because that's the problem. I'm seeing there are carriers that want to keep their customers. They're posting loads on Central for their customers, which means they're arranging for the transportation of freight and being brokers.
Yes, and 10 years ago, 15 years ago, yes, they could make a profit on that. Today, they need a broker. You look at the big trucking carriers like Schneider, J.B. Hunt, NFI, they all have a brokerage arm that handles exactly this, so that they get the big contract, they'll agree to move 10,000 units of something, and then they only can handle 5,000 or 6,000 units with their own trucks, so they have a brokerage firm to sub that work out. That is how it is supposed to work. A carrier cannot give work away to another carrier anymore under the same concepts that we used to be able to. So if you're a carrier and you're giving work away to other carriers without a broker handling the transaction, then you are breaking the rules for being a broker.
If a party is neither a broker or a carrier, how is a dispatcher gaining access to Central Dispatch? And the dispatcher's gaining access because the carrier gave it to him, because the carrier wants this third party to do some work for them on their behalf, because they either can't do it, don't want to do it, or don't have the time.
And in that instance, when the carrier gives them their login, they are definitely acting as an agent of that carrier, as long as they don't go and snoop around and find work for other people and backdoor it by calling the customer directly and taking it outside the central dispatch or whatever board they're on. If they're logging in, they're booking freight for ABC Trucking Company and logging out, then they are a bona fide agent, no ifs, ands, or buts about it.
And so does that dispatcher need a broker's license? That's what people
are
asking.
In that instance, absolutely not. In that instant where they are logged in as one carrier, close the transaction, log out, log back in with their next customer's credentials, they are an agent, not a broker.
And let me tell you why I care. Because I know that being a dispatcher, it's like being a janitor. It's kind of like that. You're near the end. You don't make a lot of money. It's very hard. It's rather thankless. So the last thing you want to know is, oh yeah, by the way, you're gonna have to cough up a couple grand to get into this business. What are you talking about? Why would you have to go get this license? It's a license for a different occupation. So being told that not only are you going to start this thankless job and you're going to be at the bottom of the pile, but oh yeah, you got to cough up a few grand or we're going to pull you over. It's honestly, it feels like harassment. And I'm tired of seeing dispatchers harassed. How about that?